Good morning, YouTube. It's your girl, Ty, Widows Chronicles, Brooklyn, New York, and via Delaware, corny ass. I'm in Wilmington. I work in Wilmington. Dry ass Wilmington. Anyway, what up? Everybody good? It's Friday. It's nasty out. We in April. We 4 months into this new year, and this shit is dry. Get out of here, 2019. 2020, come through. Pull up, because these niggas is so dry. They so corny. You know what I mean? Like, It's I don't know what's going on with life. I just want to quickly take a moment to pay my respects to Nipsey Hussle. You know, a loss is a loss, and that's tragic, and that happened earlier this week. So that's terrible. So this is very current, and our black men are dying at an enormous rate, and our children are losing their dads. Whether you married or not, a loss is a loss. It's fucked up, you know, due to gun violence, whether it be sick. Death is death. Ain't no coming back. Ain't no redos, do-overs. When that shit is done, it's done. And it's fucked up because our kids lose out on something great, getting to know someone. And now we have to teach our children about those loved ones that they lost through pictures and memories that they'll never be able to share with that individual. So my sympathy, my empathy, and my condolences goes out to his children, his family, his girl. Again, they're adults. They bounce back or whatever. It's the kids that really get affected because they didn't get to know how great or how much they was loved by that individual. People show they love. I can tell you that I love you or whatever, but I show you. So they'll miss out on an opportunity of being shown that love. So that's where it hits a soft spot with me. But on to other things. What's going on with your girl? This is something I have to share with you, okay? So I got a letter in the mail, right, the other day. And it was from an attorney. I think I got it still. Damn it. I think it's in here somewhere, but the letter was from an attorney, and I was like, who do I owe? Did I owe somebody? They suing me now? Like, damn, you ain't even give me a chance. You ain't even hit me up to say I owe a bill. So why would an attorney be trying to reach out to me, trying to hit me up? So I'm trying to tear open this letter, and I'm like, who the fuck I gotta curse out? I'm about to call people. Like, we gotta pull up. Who the fuck is suing me? I ain't even making no money like that. So why? Who's suing me? Like, you know, my mortgage is paid barely, but it's still paid. And, you know, like, what's good? Nigga. They sent a letter because out here, they have to inform you of a place if they're getting a liquor license to sell liquor in your neighborhood. And if you want to oppose it, you can go and put it in writing, go to a trial. And these motherfuckers may not get a liquor license because you want to hate and be on some bullshit like, no, I don't want you to have a liquor license, and no, you can't sell liquor. What? Do your thing. I don't care what you do. Sell coke, sell drugs, have a sex shop. As long as it don't affect me and my kids, we good. I don't care. Do your thing. All right. Thanks for the notice, you know. But that's way different. That's different than in New York. Stuff that I'm used to being in New York, you know, we only notices that we get in the mail is eviction notices, bills, even eviction notices. You know, you get your 3-day notice, you get your note on your door, and the niggas is putting you out. So lawyers don't hit you up unless they're coming for money. That's it. They don't hit you up to ask you questions. Can this person get a liquor license? Why are you asking me? Can they sell it? I guess. I don't have no nickel in that quarter. Do your thing. Like I said, level. If you getting letters from lawyers asking permission for this location, this restaurant, to have a liquor license, you moving up in the world. You doing good. Because like I said, the letters that I get from lawyers, them niggas is telling me I owe a bill, okay? And they sick of my shit. And if I don't pay it, they're going to garnish my checks and take me to the IRS and come and lock me up. That's the kind of shit I get from lawyers. Or your baby father's locked up and he said that, you know, we can use you as contact. That's the kind of lawyer shit I get. I don't get ask permission. Can a motherfucker sell liquor, crack, whatever. Whatever you want to sell, do your thing. I don't care. Like I said, don't affect me and my kids. You're good money. So that was interesting. I was like, okay. Along with that letter, all right, I was looking and in my town, I have to pay for water. Like I said, trash. I have to pay for sewer. So I was looking at that water bill and I was like, oh no. This water bill is not going to cut it. Being a New Yorker, living in an apartment, we didn't have to pay for water, okay? So I used to let my water run all day, all night. Now, I buy big bottles of water. I'm talking about shit that they deliver to your job. Them kind of water bottles. And guess what? If I have company, y'all get one jug of water. I'm filling up the tub and it might be a little cool, but that's what you're taking a bath in. You're not using my water. Are you fucking kidding me? I have already asked my son's teachers. I said, look, my son needs gym day when he gets in the morning, and he needs gym when he's going home. So he could take a shower when he goes to school and when he comes home. Take their showers, use their water. Take your toothbrush, take your toothpaste, brush your teeth, get dressed there, and come home in your pajamas so you just be ready for bed when it's time to go to bed. I'm not playing. I pay taxes. So guess what? This is what I'm using with my tax dollars. Take your motherfucking shower, get dressed, your deodorant, take your lotion, get fully dressed at school, and when you come home, come in your pajamas. Don't come here expecting to take no goddamn shower, because you'll be taking it in bottled water. And you and your sister's going to have to share that bath water. And she's younger than you, so she got to go first, because your dirt is different dirt. So don't come home thinking you could take a shower. I'm not paying that bill. No. No. If we have to eat and I have to cook with water, it's bottled water, okay? Washing clothes, no. We don't do that. We're not washing clothes. You have to wear that shit 5 times. Get the whole week wear out of it. Because when I wash, I'm washing very little. Some of that shit might be washed out by hands, okay? So when you go to school, take your underwear, wash some shits out in the sink. Don't fucking wash it in my washing machine. That's water. That's a bill. I'm not doing that. Not in 2019. Shit, they don't pay me here. Okay, I work at a local hospital here. The money ain't good. Okay? No. So, water is on strike. We on strike with water. Okay? And if you get thirsty, that big gulp, that swallow, swallow. That's all I can teach you. That's all I can tell you. Because if you get your own water bill, then you can do what you want. But with my water bill, we're going to do how I want to do. And that's you take a shower at school, you brush your teeth at school, before you start talking to people, and when you come home, you'll be good for the night. I will feed you, I will clothe you, and I'll make sure that this roof stays over your head. But as far as water's concerned, I pay taxes on their water. So guess what? Use their water over there. All right? In the summertime, what I plan on doing is buying a kiddie pool, all right? Because I got a neighbor. So I'm going to use his hose and I'm going to use his water. I'm going to fill up the pool, all right? Being Jamaican, we know how to make pits and shit. I'm going to make a fucking pit and we're going to heat that up. Bitch, we're going to have a sauna. We're going to take a bath in the fucking backyard with a sauna, okay? I'm not playing. I'm not doing that. These bills, I'm cutting down on these bills, okay? Because let me tell you about this relationship that I've been having, and I kept it under wraps, all right? But this relationship that I have, all right, this nigga, he takes care of my every need, okay? I fucked with this nigga for so long. I fucked with him and his brother, okay? When other niggas was like, nah, I can't do that for you, these niggas, they said yes, okay? I said, well, you know, when we first started, he pulled up and he was like, baby, what do you need? I said, well, right now, time is tight, so can you get me gas? He said, sure. Filled my motherfucking tank up. I was like, oh, okay. So, next time, anything else I could do for you? I said, them kids is hungry. He said, let's get them something to eat. Bought them niggas something to eat. Boom! Paid that nigga back. That nigga said, what else? I said, well, you know, I got a bill or two. Took care of that bill. Bitch, let me tell you about this nigga. He's been so good to me. Like I said, when everyone else said no, this nigga and his brother said yes. Okay? And guess what their name is? The first name is Capital. The last one is One. Capital motherfucking One. They take care of all my needs. Anything I want, the motherfuckers take care of it. Okay? When I first pulled up with him, he was like, you know, I can't give you much. He started me off with a stack. I was like, that's what's up. Okay. And that stack grew into 2 stacks, 3 stacks. I fucked around and got his brother called Platinum. And that motherfucker gave me 5 stacks off the rack. I said, oh, shit. And I didn't even have an 800 fucking credit score, bitch. Don't play with me. Now, like I said, there's levels to every fucking thing you do in life, okay? So, this other nigga from the outside world, he gonna try to pull up to me and talk to me and was like, you know, he trying to, you know, get his credit straight or whatever. So, I was like, okay, what's good? What's good? What's going on with your credit? This nigga hit me and said he was at a 420. Bitch, that's a weed day. What the fuck you mean your credit score is at a 420? The lowest you could start is at 3-something, and that's when you born, because you ain't got no motherfucking credit. You 28, 29 years old, and you gonna tell me you at a 420, nigga, 28 years later, you only a year older or 100 points over from when you was the fuck born? No, bitch, you can't talk to me. Again, levels. 4 should stay with 4. 5 should stay with 5s. 6s should stay with 6s. And if you over a 620, then you can hit up a 7 or 8. Because, like I said, I ain't no motherfucking 8. But I'm sure from a 6, bitch. Okay? So you can't come to me if your shit ain't right. And stop putting shit in your kids' motherfucking name. Let them fuck up their own credit. Because guess what? You fuck up their credit, they fuck up their credit. Ain't nobody got no motherfucking credit. Take care of your credit like you take care of everything else. I don't give a fuck what you drive. I don't give a fuck what you eat. I don't give a fuck what you live in. Take care of your credit, because that's how motherfuckers judge you, okay? And like I said, if you ain't got it, ain't nobody gonna give it to you. That's what my mom always say. So make sure you got a way to get it, all right? It been many days that my motherfucking tank been on E. And I had to pray to make it home the next day for the motherfucking check to hit. For my motherfucking paycheck to hit. I was on fumes, okay? And still drive like that. I don't give a fuck. But if I really need to stop, I can use my credit. But I use it sparingly, because, like I said, Capital One has been awesome to me. Awesome to me. And yes, they've hit me with a motherfucking late fee before and an over the limit fee. How the fuck I go over the limit? I don't know. That's what they say. But guess what? You got your money. I pay you before I pay anybody fucking else. You and my mortgage get paid. You could turn my phone off. You could turn my motherfucking cable off. Bitch, I'll even sleep in the motherfucking dark. But my credit card bill and my mortgage, gotta make sure, because if I pay that credit card bill, then I can pay for my lights. You understand? And then other stuff. So that is my rendition of Widow's Chronicles today. I'm a little hurting right now. I'm trying to see if I can coax somebody's husband into giving me a back rub. And I'll be back. You know what I mean? Hair looking all wild. Yes, I look wild every day. Because when I pull up and I'm popping, then you're going to be like, oh, she cute. Okay, that she did that. Yeah, she cute. Okay. All right, y'all have a happy Friday. Be well.